Top K and Top P in Large Language Models. A guide for investors. As investors, when evaluating the potential and capability of cutting-edge technologies like large language models, LLMs, it's crucial to understand the specifics of how they operate. Two important concepts related to the sampling strategies used by these models are Top K and Top P sampling. These methods help guide the output of the model, ensuring relevance, variety, and appropriateness. This video delves into the intricacies of these strategies, helping investors to appreciate their importance in the performance and application of LLMs. Basics of language model output. Before diving into Top K and Top P, let's briefly discuss how language models generate outputs. Language models, at each step of generating a sequence, for example, text, predict the next word based on the context of the preceding words. They provide a probability distribution over the entire vocabulary, showing the likelihood of each word being the next in the sequence. Here's where Top K and Top P come in. Instead of randomly selecting the next word from the entire distribution, these methods help in narrowing down the choices. Top K sampling. Top K sampling involves selecting the top K most likely words from the probability distribution and then sampling the next word only from this subset. Example: imagine a scenario where an LLM is prompted with, "The capital of France is." The model might assign the highest probabilities to words like Paris, A, known, etc. With top K sampling where K equals 5, the model would only consider the top 5 words with the highest probability for its next output. Pros: reduces the chances of generating highly improbable words. Provides a more controlled and predictable output. Cons: can sometimes be too restrictive, especially if K is set too low. Doesn't always capture the diversity and richness of language, leading to repetitive or cliched outputs. Top P sampling, nucleus sampling. In Top P or nucleus sampling, instead of selecting a fixed number of top words, the model selects a subset of words that have a cumulative probability exceeding a certain threshold P. Example: continuing with our earlier prompt, if the top 10 words in the probability distribution cumulatively account for 90% of the probability mass and we set P equals 0.9, then the model would sample the next word from this set of 10 words. Pros: more dynamic than Top K, adapting the subset size based on the probability distribution. Captures more diversity in outputs, reducing repetitiveness. Cons: less predictable than Top K as the number of words in the subset can vary. If P is set too high, there's a risk of generating implausible or nonsensical outputs. The mechanics behind the sampling. How sampling works. When an LLM processes a given input or prompt, it generates a probability distribution for each word in its vocabulary, estimating the likelihood of each word being the next one in the sequence. At its core, sampling techniques such as Top K and Top P are strategies to choose from this distribution. The naive approach, without any filtering, would be to randomly pick based on the provided probabilities. However, this can often lead to erratic and nonsensical results. Top K and Top P sampling help mitigate this by introducing some structure and restriction to the selection process. Entropy and exploration. At the heart of these methods lies the concept of entropy, a measure of unpredictability or randomness. A higher entropy suggests a wider spread of probabilities, indicating more unpredictability in word selection. Both Top K and Top P aim to control this entropy, but they do so in distinct ways. Top K: by selecting a fixed number of top probable words, it reduces the entropy to a constant value. Top P: by adjusting based on the cumulative probability, it dynamically controls entropy based on the context. Why not just always use high K or P values? A reasonable question to ask might be, why not always select a high K or P value to get the most probable outputs? The answer lies in the balance between creativity and coherence. Too high a value can make outputs generic and less creative. On the other hand, very low values can make the outputs too unpredictable and nonsensical. Hence, the choice of K or P is often a trade-off based on the desired application. Top K, top P sampling, and temperature. Merging temperature with top K and top P sampling further refines this process. Top K, which focuses on the most probable words, and top P, which concentrates on a probability threshold, both interact uniquely with temperature. For instance, when you have a narrowed set of words from top K sampling, the temperature can determine how random or deterministic the selection within that set will be. Similarly, with top P, the set of words based on cumulative probability can be influenced by how the temperature adjusts the underlying logits. Practically, this interplay has significant implications. For tasks that require creativity, such as generating stories or brainstorming sessions, a combination of high temperature with top P sampling might be ideal. In contrast, for more structured and specific outputs, like technical writing or FAQ responses, a lower temperature combined with top K sampling could be more appropriate. The synergy between temperature, top K, and top P in LLMs offers a robust mechanism to tailor outputs. It ensures that the results are not only accurate but also suitably adjusted for the context, making them more relevant and engaging for the intended audience. Practical implications for businesses. For businesses leveraging LLMs, the choice between top K and top P can have real-world consequences. User engagement and retention. For applications like chatbots or virtual assistants, the diversity and relevance of responses can influence user engagement. Too much repetitiveness can deter users, while too much randomness can confuse them. Content generation. Companies using LLMs for content creation, for example, news articles, product descriptions, need outputs that are both diverse and coherent. The right sampling method can help achieve this balance. Training and fine-tuning costs. Adjusting sampling strategies might sometimes necessitate additional fine-tuning of models, incurring more costs and resources. Importance for investors. Understanding the nuances of top K and top P sampling is crucial for investors for several reasons. Model efficiency and quality. The choice of sampling method can significantly influence the quality and diversity of model outputs. This has implications for user satisfaction and model utility. Customization and control. Enterprises using LLMs for specific applications might need to adjust these sampling strategies based on their requirements. A model's flexibility in this aspect can be a competitive advantage. Scaling and computing costs. Sampling strategies can influence the computational costs. For instance, very high values of K or P might require more computational power. Innovation and future development. As LLMs evolve, sampling strategies will also undergo refinements. Staying updated on these nuances can help investors gauge where the technology is headed and which companies are at the forefront of innovation. Beyond sampling, the road ahead. While top K and top P are critical components of current LLMs, the field of natural language processing is evolving rapidly. Future models might incorporate more advanced sampling methods, or even hybrid approaches that combine the best of both worlds. Investors should keep an eye on advancements in this space, as they could dictate the next big trend in LLM development and deployment. Understanding the inner workings of large language models, specifically the nuances of top K and top P sampling, is akin to peeling back the curtain on a vast realm of digital innovation. While these mechanisms may appear to be mere technical details, they are, in fact, pivotal in shaping the efficiency, creativity, and adaptability of LLMs in real-world applications. For investors and businesses alike, delving deep into these intricacies isn't just about technical comprehension, it's about harnessing the potential of a technology poised to redefine numerous sectors. As LLMs continue to evolve and transform industries, a nuanced understanding of their underlying processes will be the cornerstone of informed decision-making and future success.